track number one, which is the title song off this record. It is, of course, Dirty Mind, written by, and I have to say this, Prince and the Doctor, Dr. Fink, Matt Fink. Let's get into it. Player, why don't you start us off?
Yeah, it starts with that throbbing kick drum and bass synth. And right from the opening, it has a lot of energy and drive. And that stays throughout the song and pretty much through the whole album, when I come to think about it. The synth motif on the chorus is bright and opens up the song. Prince's vocal is a bit low and subdued for my liking. He does pick it up towards the end of the song, but that aside, the song's well-crafted, it's excellently arranged, and it's one of my favorites. It's a nice collaboration between the Dr. Fink and Prince himself. It's a great way to open the album.
All right, all right. Captain?
This song was, like you said, it was written by... Well, Prince and Mr. Fink have co-writing credit, but I think it was just that synth hook that Mr. Fink came up with, so that's why he got co-writing credits on the track. But I don't think he had much else. I think everything else was Prince anyway. But it's nice synth work all through the track. This would have been a great dance floor track. Imagine, you know, I wasn't there. I was three. But imagine if you're in a nightclub in 1980 and this came on, you know, blasting in the speakers. That would have been good. With that bass and the synth, that would have just blown your head off back in 1980. It would have been good. But this is the title track of the album. It was a good title track. It fits the concept more than any other track on this album. It's got good backing vocals. That's about it.
You know, you mentioned if you would have heard that song as a, I guess, as an adult or a teenager when it came out. And I think you're onto something there, Captain, because it's like it's a pretty out there song. You know what I mean? It's not like Sadie the cleaning lady or anything like that. It's not, and it's not Twist and Shout either. It's like he's going for the. I won't say he's going for gold, but he's really like just, it's salacious. That's what it is. I'm not going to mince my words. Yeah, that's right. So
I think it has got that sort of predator thing about it, hasn't it? It's like
predator.
You know, yeah, no, in the sense of like, you know, he's going out with this girl and he's trying to play nice, but in the back of his mind, he's got these dirty thoughts going on.
You know what you just reminded me of?
Who?
You know, in Family Guy, there's that old guy.
I don't know.
The way he talks, you know, now that you remind me of it, the way that he talks reminds me of the way Prince whispers the first parts of this song with that really light voice.
Well, that's what I was thinking when Player said, you know, that his vocals are a bit low in the mix. I think that's deliberate. I think that's because, like you're saying, it's this sort of, he's got this little dirty secret that, you know, that he knows that no one else knows, that he's thinking all these disgusting thoughts.
No one
else.
Yeah,
like, I agree with that. But also, too, if you listen to all the songs in the sequence, it's really only until Party Up where he starts to get, like, really aggressive in the vocal. Most of the vocal, the way he sings the songs on this album, it's very, very low or quiet.
Yeah.
But anyway.
I like how you say that they're his secret dirty thoughts that no one else knows. And then I'm thinking to myself, aside from the 100,000 people that bought the record.
Yeah.
You know. But I think the funny thing, just before I go to you, Tejem, on this, the funny thing about this track as well that I only recently found out was the B-side was When We're Dancing Close and Slow. And I'm thinking, oh, how romantic, you know, in comparison to side A. Good move, Prince. So yeah, Tejem, what are your thoughts?
Yes, funky track. There's the video for this, isn't there? For this one and Uptown on this, from the same setup. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
I like those two videos. They're really, just like the album, they're kind of raw. The instrumentation on this is pretty small. Well, it's pretty much all the way through the album. It's sort of the same instrumentation on each song, which is really good from an album point of view, I think. I like albums that have like a, you know, thematic sound to them, unlike Sign of the Times and that sort of stuff. Like, that's good as well, but it's like every song has a different set of instruments, a different combination, whereas this is like, no, we're just doing drums, bass, a couple of guitars, you know, piano, and maybe five or six vocals, and that's pretty much it, the whole album, which is just awesome. So really, you get to do a whole lot of interplay stuff, which comes up more in the album, I guess. The synth hook thing that we're talking about, I reckon that Jump song, Van Halen Jump song, was influenced by this song. Because, yeah, that's got a real similar sound, similar kind of groove. And for anyone who's wondering, so there's, you got C on the bass, and then it's doing a G major second inversion, and then an F major second inversion, and then down to C major first, like just normal inversion. So that's the riff if you're out there. The lyrics are very suggestive, and, you know, every now and then he's talking about he wants to do it in his daddy's car and underneath the stars, and but, you know, he'll give you some money to go along with him. So it's kind of like, you know, there's a bit of prostitution in there too as well. The clean guitar sound sounds really cool, and lots of power chords on this album, clean power chords. It's kind of a instrumental theme throughout the album. Just really funky, really dancey. Yeah, great opening track and a good theme setter.
The weird thing with that synth hook is it's really clashy, but somehow it doesn't sound like it is.
Yeah.
It's well, just, got, like, it, somehow it works. Like you're yeah. saying, it's in C, right? But the first note is also a B. How can you play B yeah. and C? It just doesn't work, but it does. I don't understand that.
Yeah, and it's got a
anyone,
D in there as
anyone,
well.
Anyone, so just go and play yeah. C and B on a keyboard right now and hear how horrible it sounds.
Well, that's
and
the
then
thing.
Listen
sounds,
to this song and but, it works.
But what you've got in between it, you've got a D and a G in between it, so it's spaced out nicely. So your ear yeah. hears that B as being not so close to the C.
It's just weird.
Yeah, well, I agree with what you guys have said about the track, really. I mean, in a nutshell, it's real funky. It's a great opener. It's new wave salacious funk to me. You know, those punchy synth chords that everyone mentioned and the driving beat, great raw piercing vocals. That's all true. But the other thing that really strikes me on this is everything is mixed so tight. But I say tight, what I really mean is dry. Like, it's really dry mixing. And maybe it's because it wasn't, you know... it wasn't overly mixed in post-production or anything like that. It just sounds like, I don't know, to me it sounds like underground music. Maybe because it's because of the look that he was going for and because he hadn't quite, you know, he hadn't hit the big time yet. It's just like underground Minneapolis funk and it's really, really nice to listen to. And something about the melody is also kind of playful. And all the way up until about the 2:36 mark.
Is you a really bad yeah,
that's right. And see, what Captain just did, that pretty much continues up until the 2:36 mark, when the song just explodes with these piercing vocals and lots of intent on the part of Prince, with that rhythm guitar just chiming along constant and gritty under the you know, the lead melody line. But the synths, just to close off, they make me feel like an ambulance or something is on its way to get a patient in need, you know? It's like... It's just a really weird feeling. I'm listening to this song and I'm listening to him sing about his dirty mind and the thoughts that in his mind and all that kind of stuff. And it's like, it's almost like an emergency. Like he needs
it's
to get
that,
there quick.
It's that chord with those two clashing notes that just does something.
Yeah, it must be. It must be the B and C that you guys were talking about, you know? Yeah, I mean, the energy's high, but it's also a little bit kind of something odd about it. And maybe it comes down to what Tojem and Captain were talking about. But yeah. Great opening track, but a minor classic. You know, I think this is a classic Prince song, but a minor one. It's not really one of the, you know. Anyway, I'll leave it there.
The other thing I'll say is towards the end of the song, you get the synth strings just playing dun, 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 almost like Psycho kind of thing. And he brought that back for the classic Everybody Loves Me on 2010.
That's true.
Yeah, if
That's
you listen to true. Everybody Loves Me, you listen to all the instrumental stuff, it's very much coming from this song, so.
But see, that whole album was a throwback to this era.
Hmm.
Yeah.
All right. So that covers track number one. Let's go into